The red slanting roofs playing hide and seek between the lush green trees, with the Mandovi keeping an eye on them. As we drove to our hotel, the views were magnificent. The clouds floating in the sky, the vast sea, the casinos, the fishing boats, and the distant Mandovi Bridge all seemed so magical. Now, Goa has a very special place in our heart, as my mother-in-law's family comes from Goa, and so it is practically our second home. And we have in fact lived in Panaji for a couple of years. Our stay this time was at the Surya Kiran Heritage Hotel. Like its name, this is a bright little heritage hotel right in the heart of Panaji, just 3 minutes from the Kampal Garden. A 100-year-old Portuguese bungalow turned into a 6-room hotel. Beautiful location and amazing hospitality. A perfect blend of the old world charm, modern amenities, friendly owners and efficient staff. They have beautifully maintained spacious rooms with gorgeous vintage furniture. The room opens in this veranda where you can cast all your worries aside and relax. Now, I have always loved houses with verandas. They allow a sense of serenity to trickle down into the house. This is a nostalgic blast into the past. After sipping some tea, we set out. So Goa has many faces, the most well-known being the stunning beaches, the heritage churches, and the vibrant nightlife. But is there tourism beyond these? Goa says yes, there is. So come, let's take a walk around and soak in the vibes of Panaji. Panaji, the capital of Goa, is one of the most stunning state capitals in India. The place has a history that dates back to the Vedic age. Just opposite to the hotel is this beautiful garden. The renovated building of Asia's first medical college is just nearby, which now serves as the headquarters of the Entertainment Society of Goa. Panaji's Miramar Beach is the longest in Goa. Stretching as far as 2 kilometers, the beach lies on the confluence of the Mandovi River and the Arabian Sea and offers a splendid view. There is a long and wide promenade all along the river and is at present undergoing re-imaging. These beautiful avenues are lined with gulmohar, acacia and other trees. Another architectural icon is the Kala Academy, where we have spent many evenings in the past. It is the premier institute in the field of art and culture and sadly is closed at present for renovation. It is situated on the riverfront and not many people know that the sunset from here is stunning. In fact, it is one of the best in Goa. So please make it a point to visit this place whenever you are here. The Goa State Museum in Panji is located in the old Secretariat building, which was Adil Shah's palace. The entry here is free. One of the iconic landmarks in Panji. This church was built in 1541 and later replaced by a bigger church in the 1600s. It is one of the most revered churches and famous for its eye-catching zigzag stairs, making it one of the most photographed sites in Goa. On the corner near the church is the Singhbal Book House. It is the oldest and most popular bookstore in Panji. The third Mandovi Bridge, also known as the Atal Setu, is a bridge that connects between Panji and Porvorim. Only 4-wheelers are allowed on this third longest cable stayed bridge in India. Just nearby, on the top of the Altino Hills, is this 100 years old stunning Hanumanji temple. It is beautifully lit at night and is easily visible from a distance. The temple overlooks the fontanas, also known as Latin quarters. In our upcoming video, we will be taking a heritage walk through the fontanas in Panji. Friends, if you have any, please share your experiences of Goa with all of us in the comment section. As always, we will look forward to your comments. Till then, goodbye. See you soon.